my good friend Amit Agarwal ji, Amit Gupta ji, Dr. Amit Dhar, Major General M.P. Singh, members of the faculty, all distinguished guests, and the student community from GYMS. I wish to express my gratitude to Dr. Dhar for inviting me to deliver this particular lecture. Several years ago, in my first term as Lieutenant Governor, there was a function at the Talcahuana Stadium organized by the then Chief Minister, Mr. Sahib Singh Verma. And that had about 3,000 teachers in the audience. The banner at the back of the podium was Bharat Punah Ho Vishwa Guru, a very good mission objective. Bharat Punah Ho Vishwa Guru. What is the unique legacy and distinction of our country is something every Indian who is fortunate to be born in this sacred soil must appreciate. As Commerce Secretary, I have travelled across the world. 3.5 years, I think, one of the longest stints. So many bilateral meetings, multilateral, regional meetings. No country in the world has the basic air of calm, peace, brotherhood, tolerance, mutual respect which India has. This is our born legacy from 5,000, 10,000 years of history of our unique country in the world. A couple of years ago, I heard a lecture organized by TERI, the Delhi Sustainable Development Summit. The president of Iceland, Gustav Grimsson, he had come as the chief guest. He said at a time when the world is moved dramatically towards globalization, people are crossing national political boundaries, economic spaces, there is a churning of global ideas. European Union has come into existence, other groupings have come in Latin America. They are transferring from one country to the other in search of jobs. The economic space has got integrated. When people travel and start living in different environments, cultural, social, ethnic, linguistic, they need to adapt so that they can blend into their host societies and make a positive contribution to the system of way of life, production, distribution, services, etc. His observation was the one country in the world where people have an unbroken record of more than 2,000 years of peaceful coexistence amidst plurality and diversity is India. In so many other countries, France, for instance, they said, we don't want religious symbols in public places, public schools. You are allowed not to wear this, you cannot wear kirpan, you cannot wear headdress, you cannot wear burqa or something. India has no limitation. Do what you please. When I was commercial counselor in England, I lived in an apartment building, the ground floor of which there was some German Jewish couple who had migrated at the time of the anti-Jewish persecution in Germany, late 1930s. They came. We used to meet occasionally, they were an elderly couple, we used to play Scrabble. And he once took out a book, this thick book, History of the Jewish People. He said, I'm proud to tell you there's a whole long chapter on Jews in India. And the unique experience of the Jewish people, India was one country where there was never any persecution of the Jews on the grounds of their religious faiths and tenets. So India has that unique distinction. Also, if you see in the Western society, and I studied there also, and I have so many occasions to travel, the whole concept is aggression. To get ahead, you know, in competition, life is very competitive, rat race, you are very aggressive. You elbow people around and then try and move ahead. If you see all American movies and other things, people are abusing each other, shouting at each other, trying to see, we can dominate you. What is the culture in the Oriental society? They say, मिटा दे अपनी हस्ती को अगर कुछ मर्तबा चाहिए कि दाना खाक में मिलकर गुले गुजार होता है humility. They said that it is दान के दान को लोडे फ्रूट दांच बेंड्स इट बेंड्स डाउन. We have a unique legacy. We said four major goals of human life: dharma, art, kaam, moksha. Ethical conduct, moral conduct. You earn your livelihood by honest means. Fulfill your desires and worldly obligations and other things, and ultimately go for the final stage, which is seeking God realization and full expression of the innate divine potential in every human being. Transparency International today describes India as a country which has one of the worst records in honesty in the public domain. I asked at a conference, national conference of Lokayukas, at the Gyan Bhavan on the 2nd of November 2012, which was attended by the Honorable President of India, the Chief Justice of India, the Law Minister, Prime Minister's Secretary, Minister of State, Mr. Narayan Swamy, so many others. I said, why does a country which is full of temples, mosques, gurdwaras, churches, attended by millions of people every day, there is no country in the world where a place of religious worship has so much of, you know, participation by people who have faith and who are seeking Almighty's blessings. In a country like this, where they have said dharma, artha, kaam, moksha, earn your livelihood by honest means, why should it be necessary for there to be CBI, Anti-Corruption Bureau, CVC, Comptroller General of India? Can't people stay within the ethical boundary on an autonomous basis? Why should there be enforcement? Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru said the test of a people's fitness for democracy is directly proportionate to their level of self-discipline and self-regulation. If you cannot regulate yourself, people will have to enforce things. Take out a stick. But then that is question. We are moving away from liberal society and liberal democracy into something which is imposed. These are questions every single Indian must ask himself. What is the value system by which he wishes to live his life? Is it more important to have a faster car, more air conditioners in the house, and, you know, fancy these bands which are there for your handbags and shoes? Or is it more Indian, more becoming to live within your honest means, be grateful to the Almighty, enjoy peace of mind? The moment somebody breaches the code of honesty and integrity, always a fear complex starts. Pata nahi kab CBI ki raid pad jayegi. Are we going to live a life out of fear only? Where the fear is overhanging our consciousness, we have done something wrong, we have taken away somebody else's right. Something has come which did not belong to us by honest means. Are we going to live like this? Every Indian must make up his mind. Does he want to add to India's core brand equity, or does he want to weaken it? And in my view, any Indian who is violating the ethical code as a personal commitment, he is stripping away India's brand equity in terms of not only the national space but the international space. As Commerce Secretary, I was in Zambia once at Lusaka. We were having an exclusive trade fair. Just shortly before I landed in Lusaka, The Zambian newspapers were full of news items. Some Indian merchant exporter of pharmaceutical products, medicines, managed to get some product cheap on the market, which was ending the period of its validity. It has a 3-year validity when you manufacture drugs or medicines. After 3 years, it is no longer fit for prescription. You must have bought it cheap. 2 years have already gone by, it's an African country. By the time the goods actually got cleared from the ships and all that, brought into transportation, trains and whatever else, the expiry of the medicines had already, that date had been crossed. The whole of Zambian papers that Indian exports are unreliable. They are trying to basically dump rubbish, on the market here. The whole country got a kind. While some merchant exporter from profit motive, he did something which was unbecoming. And it damaged the national reputation. Now these days, people say, all this advertising which is going on, that making money is important, yes. A person can earn money honestly also. To such extent as it is written in his karmic account, kitna paisa isko milna. But if you breach the ethical code and start doing things which are inappropriate, I think it's something in which they are seriously damaging their personal lives, their peace and their happiness, but are also creating a very negative impact on the rest of society. Then, these days also, in terms of behavior, it's become very trendy how beer bars, that's our drinks. Okay, some states in the US, I was there over December, January, they have now legalized marijuana as an entertainment drug. So Colorado was the first state. People are queuing up to buy marijuana so that they can have it in the evening and get a kick. Hamare itne mahatma the, itne guru sahiban the, they never had marijuana to get kicks. Guru Nanak Dev Ji said, kaun-kaun si unhone zikr kiya, utar jaye prabhat naam kumari naam ka chali rahe dilara. Indians must decide, are they going to simply blindly copy the kind of cultural waves which are coming and cultural images which are coming from the West? Or are they going to retain a strong anchorage in the Indian ethics, Indian value system and Indian priorities? In the West, as you know, what is the divorce rate now? 50-60%. Within 2 years, I don't like you, the other person said I don't like you, parting from you. Children are absolutely left at large. There are no emotional security, no financial security. People are fighting like cats and dogs. The result is American children's academic performance in the institutions of learning is on the lowest. Which are ones which are having higher academic performance? Indians, Chinese, because their family systems are more traditional. The families are stable. We still believe in the dictum, till death do us part, we are going to be there. I said openly in a lecture about almost 8-9 years ago, it was again a passing out lecture for a master's in diploma management. I said if people believe that by getting into butterfly relationships, they are going to emerge as top priced professionals, they can forget it. If you do not have a stable and strong emotional anchorage at home, from a very strong and supportive family, you can forget about being a top management, you can have all the PhD degrees, you will be a third-rate man. You will not be able to deliver. People get into self-destructive habits, Let us try smoking, let us try drinking, let us try party drugs. Why should we try it? You are reaching a particular choice. Why are you making a choice which is self-destructive? God has given me a unique opportunity with so many energies, physical energy, mental energy, spiritual capability. Use it. Disaster if you start getting into wrong things. Four friends get together. Chalo, two bhi glass pad le. Kyun pad liye? Kisne kya? Learn to make up your own mind. When you are getting into higher education, learn to make up your mind, stand as an individual who is firmly anchored in a certain value system and priorities of your own. Finish. Let the world say that you do like this, I will not do it. So many new batches of IAS officers and IPS officers have come to meet me at Taj Nivas every year. New batches used to come for courtesy call. My one advice to them was maintain one single savings account throughout your career. A savings account is God. Whatever you do should be approved in the eyes of God Almighty that this is fair, it is born out of compassion, a spirit of selfless service to your fellow human beings. It is motivated by a sense of justice, fair play, not obliging somebody. Not that a politician gives you a call or some other influential person gives you a call. Ye aise karo. Kyun karo? Usko naukri de do. Kyun de? The Article 16 of the Constitution says, all public employment is equally available. Opportunity for employment is open to all Indian citizens. That is Article 16. I said, create a reputation where you say that I have been given a certain power of being recruited into a certain service by God Almighty, no politician appointed you. It was your merit, you worked hard, you crossed the competitive hurdles, you got an appointment. Use that vested power to build up a savings account with one single apartment, super apartment. I made a director on two Tata companies also during the term of in between. I chaired the advisory board of the Standard Chartered Bank of UK, so Tata boards. I chaired the board of Bank Vaccine Laboratories, and since we are here, I must tell you. Firstly, I was not executive chairman, but all this news which is appearing against Rand Vaxi. Rand Vaxi's medicines that they made and put in, you know, it's a very complex molecule and it is synthesized by a number of steps of chemical reaction. The medicines made by Rand Vaxi are perfectly valid and good in clinical practice. The only thing where the Americans have found fault with Rand Vaxi medicines is that in the subsequent documentation, they found there are some slippages. They say every batch which is made has to be kept in storage. Every 6 months, you take out a little sample, test it for efficacy, write your reports, put it back. Another 6 months pass, again you take out a sample, little piece of that sample. I started looking into this only when this problem came. The French charity called Médecins Sans Frontières, Doctors Without Borders, gave a public statement from Paris. Rand Vaxi medicines are found to be perfectly effective in clinical practice. Now the FDA, the Food and Drug Administration in the United States, has very cleverly in their definitions of adulteration, they say, that if a supplier of a drug doesn't keep proper documentation, the drug will be treated as adulterated. Our definition of adulteration is some foreign matter is added to it. दूध में आप बहुत ज़्यादा ये मिला दो, पानी मिला दो, ये कर दो, यूरिया मिला दो, that is adulteration. Rand Vaxi medicines are not adulterated in the conventional understanding. Dr. Devi Shetty, the great cardiac surgeon, he appeared in IPM, CNN interview. few months ago when all this news was coming up in the newspapers, and he said, I carry out open heart surgery in the United States. I carry out open heart surgery in India. In India, I fill a single page patient report. Patient had this problem, this was operated. Signed, they wish it. In USA, I have to fill 30 pages of information. Does it mean that my operation carried out in India is less effective than the open heart surgery carried out in the United States? They have played a clever game, and under the pressure of multinationals like Sony, Pfizer, GlaxoSmithKline, Schering Plough, they don't want to see competition from a generic producer. Point I was coming to was that if we want to see India really take its place on the high table in the global community, firstly, India must stand true to its USP. Its USP is a country which believes in plurality, diversity, tolerance. It's a country which respects family values. It's a country which respects the value system of probity in public life. Which country is going to respect us if Transparency International says that out of 215 countries, we are ranked in the Transparency Index is 158? Who is going to bother about this? That means that nothing can be done without money changing hands. Why? The other thing is that, each one of us, in whatever career choices we are making and will make, ultimately decide to do something. I decided that I will run for the civil service. God grace, I got it. Now the question is, once you have chosen what you wish to do, you have to then be in your own, the mirror of your conscience. You have to be committed to discharging that particular duty in what I call, in the manner of a gold standard profession, gold standard. From which I mean, number one, total commitment to ethical integrity and honesty. Total commitment. If you are an engineer, there's no question of kickbacks by contractors. If you are a doctor, there's no question of kickbacks from the pathological testing labs. Everybody knows the story today. The more references you give to a us lab se krao, 20-30% is going to come back to the prescribing doctor. I know I have nobody to say Dharamdarji is sitting there, but I have said if you are going to do these things, then please make an advance reservation, 15-year time gap in the Scots Heart Center for a room for yourself. Because nature is unforgiving. Sooner or later, the accounts will have to be cleared. Number one, total integrity and honesty. Number two, very high domain knowledge. You must know your domain very well. And domain knowledge does not mean only learning and restricting itself to yesterday's learning or today's. It's a constant learning effort to keep yourself updated. As a doctor, as an engineer, as a lawyer, as an accountant, as a civil servant. The effort to learn. Niraj Chaudhary ji also wrote those beautiful books, Autobiography of an Unknown Indian, The Continent of Sarsa. He said Indians are endowed with fantastic intellectual ability. They say, use it or lose it. Learn to use it. Keep on wetting it on a sharp stone and acquire more relevant learning. And third, from a high caliber professional is the expectation that he will be ready to discharge his accepted duty autonomously and on his own without any supervision, prodding, and constant reminders. In all our offices, organizations, we say he is a worker. If you tell him what to do, you can forget about it, you'll see that it's done. He will not shirk the effort to get it done. There are some as they say, keep on whipping the horse, only then it runs. Some tell the Tonga and Sartre, if you want to be a top-class professional, accept that responsibility that once I'm given a job, I will stand up. Now, I have also said on similar occasions that when you are seeking job offers and so many companies will come and you can have campus recruitment and other opportunities are also open. I know you are looking for a job, you are looking for a good salary package. But please see what is the ethical value system in that organization. Are they also committed to high standards of ethics or are they willing to make compromises? And my sense is, of course, that if you want to be an Indian that the country can be proud of, you will draw the line. This is not an organization I'm prepared to work. I can assure you, other doors will. You come to the crossroad, this work culture, this reputation does not meet my ethical standards. Forget it. Other goes to go. And whenever you are faced with a situation in which somebody asks you to do something which is not proper, which does not fit in with your ethical standards, with your professional outlook, you have to simply draw the line and say, I'm getting off this bus. Move away. Now I have seen from the civil service, I've had very long experience. Since I joined the service now to be 54 years. If you build a reputation that you are not going to become a doormat for a politician, that reputation will safeguard you like anything from time to time. Now you are going to get into management fields and so many things. Keep up your own filters, you know, how far you want to go, where you want to go, etc. Also, I would say that in terms of the requirements of good citizenship, while you are a good professional, you are also a citizen of our great country. And one comment which President Abdul Kalam ji had made once he addressed the Indian School of Business as the President of he said it's a very strange phenomenon that when Indians migrate to other countries, they become the ideal citizens of that country. All laws, regulations are being followed meticulously in Singapore, in London, in United States. Very fine. All high marks. When they come to the country or they are residing in this country, they think it is their born right under the Constitution to violate all laws, regulations made by our legislators and other people for the good of society. He says, how can this country ever progress? People will boast, I say my cross all red lights. People say, I stay within the boundary of law. I'll give you an example. When I was commercial counselor in England, one night I took to Mr. Christopher Roberts, who was a director in the Department of Trade and Industry of the British government, to an Indian dinner. We were in the area of Knightsbridge, a very good Indian restaurant, and we finished our dinner around 11:30 at night. I was driving my car with a CV number plate. Christopher Roberts was sitting next to me. As we were driving, little ahead, the light turned red. There was segregated traffic. We were on this side. A thing was coming from the other direction. To Delhi traditions, I just went through the red light and crossed. Christopher Robert told me, he says, Tejinder, I know that you have a diplomatic number plate and nobody will book you for a traffic violation. But the next time you decide to commit a traffic violation, please make sure that a servant of Her Majesty's government is not sitting in your car. So that is a sense of autonomous compliance. Even the night, I'll come to a stop. So, when we talk about, you know, leadership requirements for resurgent India, what is India? India is, after all, composed of, it's a landmass, but 1.25 billion individuals constitute the country of India. For each of the Indians, it has to be their personal commitment to the core values of Indians. And as I told you and I repeated, the first is unity in diversity, religious tolerance, family values, cohesive family structures, respect for women, another core Indian value, very badly represented and observed in our societies. When I was the MG in 2007, in the month of May itself, I gave a direction that all 1100 Delhi government schools will ask all boys in classes from 8 to 11 onwards to sign an annual pledge that throughout their life they will only show the utmost respect, consideration, and protection for women. Each boy has to sign that, and with a hope, a groom is created in their minds. Navaratra, we celebrate Mati Shakti ki puja. So many times we are, all temples are full, prasad is being offered, Mata ke beta being sung. What about the Mati Shakti in our homes? How are we treating our sisters, daughters, parents, mothers? These are not things which are negotiable. Any home in which Matri Shakti is not worshipped, respected, cannot be sustained. It will deteriorate into disaster sooner or later. How do we cultivate? Each one has to make up its mind. No amount of policing can all this say. Newspaper show, aap phir itne rape ho gaye. What is the police going to do? Can it start policing the thought process of people's minds? But I would say that all of you, because you are from a very prestigious management institute and you will fill positions of responsibility in organizations. Maybe in your span of responsibility it will be 30, maybe 100 as you grow more senior. 5. In my view, you must gauge every single person working under your sphere of influence and control. Is he a really true class gold standard Indian or not? He or she? And if not, please do your duty to mentor the person. Don't destroy yourself. Please tread the path of propriety, of elevation, of evolution. And if you find deviant behavior is continuing, ask them to leave. They don't deserve to be in that organization. An organization is not only successful if it makes money. Yes, money is a part. A person who is at peace, living in a hut, is far better off than a person who is living in a palace and his mind is under a state of turbulence and dis-ease and anxiety and worry. He cannot buy peace with all his bank accounts and his assets. That's why in Gurbani also, in the Anasar part, they say, Kar shant sukhman aaye vasya, ichha sab pujaiya, sada kurban ki ta gurvitno jisne aaye vanya. Kar shant sukhman aaye vasya, shant, shant, shant. If we are going to have that peace within ourselves, I was a young officer at Civil Secretariat Chandigarh. We had a lift going up to our house. It's a 10-story building, as you know. A glass plank is still there. It's saying, by Confucius, if you want peace in the country, you must have peace in society. If you want peace in society, you must have peace in the family. And if you want peace in the family, you must have peace within yourself. Are we going to live lives of peace and happiness? Peace and happiness is what we are all looking for. Or are we going to hand out injustice to our neighbors? Building bylaws violated, you are allowed only 3 floors, you build 4 floors. You die the municipal engineer, the police chat. Brag at home, they call him a chauthi mandir bhi kaat nahi. Chauthi mandir kaat nahi, naal wale the, dhokar rok nahi, hawa rok leya, ते फिर उनका की कमियाँ तो हमें वो भी बदतुआ लग गई थी देखो ये से सारे ना धक्का की क्यों अरे डोंट डू दी सिली थिंग्स बाहर में जब वो नेचर के अपने झंडे चलते हैं तो बच्चा को दो पार्टन के बीच में सावध रहा है सब जग पिस्ता देख के दास कबीरा रोए दो पार्टन के बीच में So I want to tell you, you talk about resurgent India, India is a great country, visionary leadership, yes, we all need it. But each one has to look into the mirror and say, am I a true Indian? Am I adding to India's national and global brand equity or not? Amir Khan comes out in these TV small clips. A foreign tourist lady has come. She is trying to board a three-wheeler. Some ruffians try to misbehave. Somebody comes forward and says, stop doing this. Don't bother that. And then, aap kaun hote ho? Main desh ko kaam. Okay? Shame. Should be our attitude. You come out all with lovely degrees, you know. I think, by the way, I was very happy to hear the background given by Amitji. I have a feeling that this is a school which has a very strong commitment to ethical values. And I would say to you, have a provision that if any of the alumni of this institution are found to be breaching the ethical code in the course of their service careers, the institute will have the right to withdraw the diploma. I am only trying to say, make up a personal mind of your own. Don't be like sheep. Be tigers, tigresses. Make up your mind. Then India will be a great country. We will be able to provide visionary leadership to a resurgent India. And people deal with, today they are saying, international agencies are seeking out Indian executives for manning their global operations. Why? Indians are highly intelligent. God has given them fantastic intellectual capability. Fantastic. They are also very adaptive. They adapt in different cultures. Some years ago, the Norwegian ambassador met me in India. He said, we have Indians and Pakistanis both who have come migrated to Oslo, capital of Norway. He said, we find the Indians are able to merge into our social environment very nicely. They attend each other's parties, the children will play with each other and everything, invite leisure festivals. He said, unfortunately, our experience with Pakistani migrants is very different. They like to go to a ghetto, they don't mix. Indians have an ability to adapt, to mix. That's why they prefer such people who can dovetail and basically build good teams around. So all of you will have all of those advantages as you rise in your careers, but I'm only saying that please maintain a very, very strong commitment to ethical values, to the Indian traditions, intellectualism, family values. None of this business of butterfly religion. Chalabera. I don't know Bengali.
At the end of it, I think you should monitor
how things go with all your wonderful graduates who pass out. But today I would certainly hope and pray by God's grace. Firstly, you have great professional success, also you have great personal happiness. And the only way to ensure that, to take steps towards that, is to keep very strongly committed to your core ethical values and values of the two traits of Indianness. Don't stop being Indians. Don't become Americans. Don't become French. Please be Indians. I can assure you, I know we don't have choices, but all Muslim leaders who have met me, so many of them, there is no country in the world for Muslims as no restriction. You worship as you like, you pray as you like, you go for your Hajj. Nobody is saying, that person just came the other day here in Saudi Arabia. He says, what do I say? People can't stop all kinds of restrictions. Really, I say to them, I have often said that relationship is between you and God. Who is the third party to interfere? Clear karma. It depends on is God happy with me or not. My final point is, beyond all ethics, the root of all ethical and moral behavior is the underlying law of love. Guru Gobind Singh Ji said, Saaj kahun sunne aur samay jina prem ki o tin hu la. Guru Nanak Dev Ji said, Nanak naam chardi kala tere bhaan sarvat da. Sarve bhavantu sukhina. Sabka bhala. When we become selfish ki apna bhala ho dusra jaye dozak mein, to phir nahi. Phir wo chardi kala nahi hogi, dhatdi kala hogi. The laws of nature. Let me wish you all the very, very best. May God Almighty give you the inspiration, the light, the strength to conduct yourself as true Indians. And people who believe in love and compassion, because somebody asked Dalai Lama, which is the best religion in the world. He said, that religion which teaches its followers compassion, selfless service, that is the best religion. Vaishnava Dhamma Sotele Kaye Peer Parayi Jante. If we have that feeling, how can we be unfair and unjust to God? We'll be very nice and loving to God all. There is a family outside. Can we be of help? Where is the aggression? Where is the dance hola? Then we become truly an elevated and civilized society. If we go on for all this kind of differences and clashes, because somebody is calling the Almighty by the name of Allah, Allah, by you, the Lord, Rama, Krishna, if we start fighting, is the most ridiculous thing for a person to do. He is saying that I am an emotion of love. We want to relate to him by fighting with his creatures. Number batate hain ki dekho ji humne itne shaheed kar diye. Aur usse poocho qubool bhi hai ki nahi shahadat wahan par to sirf kehte hain sahib ke darbar mein kewal bhakti pyar. One currency is accepted in that court, love, compassion, service, humility. Please understand these things. Make it a part and parcel of your life. I think you will be very happy as individuals, you will contribute to family happiness, you will contribute to social peace, to national development, and thereby, from your positive vibrations, to international peace and good. Now, I close by again expressing my deep gratitude to Amit Gupta ji, to Dr. Ravi Dharsa. He was kind enough to come to us really and suggest that I should share this perception, these perceptions with you. And I know at the end of the day, it's all a question of receptivity. If your own experiences have prepared you to receive something, you receive it. It comes like a mirror. That I finally leave to God's good judgment. Thank you.